50th Olympiad at Squaw Valley, USA, 1993. As you can see, we have quite a turnout today here at Squaw Valley. Beautiful sun out in the California sky. We got little snow-capped trees and
Brian, tell me, they are ready.
Here we have our local correspondent here to the Tahoe area, Lynn Mullen.
Yes, and I am here, I came out for Jim's birthday party. I want to tell you, I'm so happy this party is coming on. We have been waiting so long for this party to happen, and I know this group has been out there practicing. They feel strong.
And good morning, America, from Squaw Valley, USA. Take it away.
And she came out all the way from Colorado for this race. She feels strong. I know she was out stretching this morning along with Jim. But I think we do need to bring on our special guest, our man of the day, who is going to have a very special surprise for us later. How about a big birthday applause for Jim Mullen?
Well, thank you. We're going to have a big day out there. I can't wait to see what I'm going to do. You know, after I learned how to ski at Squaw Valley, USA.
Still learning.
30 years ago. Actually, I only came up here because Tammy said she was willing to stay at the Squaw Valley Inn. 30 years later, we're here for the confession time.
Please be nice. Tammy's a guest star tonight at dinner.
Oh, my God.
She's coming out of the cake later.
We've had a lot of requests. We've had a lot of requests for this, but I'm going to do it anyway. I'm going to reenact the great blindfold drive of 1960. I'm going to do the blindfold drive, you guys, the blindfold ski, you guys.
Oh, can't wait for that. What a guy.
With my face covered, I'm going to face the slalom course. Lynn, make sure that they're right there with the ski patrol.
Oh, Jim,
and would you introduce some of our guests here, Lynn, and kind of take the responsibility away? Thanks, everybody.
I certainly will. Now, first, we'll start here with our gal and yours, Jill. Don't get near this girl when she's sailing a boat. Gregory. Hi, Jill.
Hi.
Are you happy to be here, Bob?
Oh, I'm so excited to be here. I've been training and training.
Well, you know, I had these guys coming for you, but unfortunately, I guess they had to wash their hair, so they're not here. I'm sure they'll show up after, Jill. Okay? Good to see you. Bryce Griffith, one of the all-time sailors. Oh, that's right. And there's a little woman, Donna. And do we have our little child over?
He's in snow school, and he's not liking it.
You do?
This could be a short morning.
And Bryce is going to be out there on the race course and is another good, excellent one. Oh, we have a surprise guest.
Hi, I'm Nancy Cushing. And
hi, Nancy.
I'm really thrilled that you're all here, and I want to meet Jim.
Well, here he is. Is Alex washing his hair? I thought he was going to come over.
He came here at 8:20, and he came here at 8:35. I don't know how he missed you.
I don't either, because we're sort of obvious. But you see, here we have Nancy anyway. This is important.
Well, anyway, maybe I'm not as good, but I'm
here. Oh, I don't think so. This is Jim.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
You know, we've had a lot of fun in Squaw Valley, and thanks for making it so great for us for all these years.
Now we have the shirt. We have the shirt
Where's
for Alex.
Shirt?
Where's the extra shirt? Well, we have a shirt for Alex with his name on it. I'm sorry. He may be seeing us up here skiing today.
Okay, we'll look for you out on the hill.
Jim's doing his famous skiing. He's a magician, you know, and he's doing his famous blindfold ski down the race course today.
All right.
So
covered.
I'm impressed.
The face is going to be completely covered with gauze pads. Completely covered.
Okay, that's enough of that, Jim. We're tired of that. Okay, enough about him.
How long has Jim been skiing at Squaw Valley?
30 years.
30 years.
I learned to ski at Squaw Valley.
And he's still learning. we still see those little orange boots out there, and we follow those little boots wherever we can. Right, Jim? Hey, where are my twins? We have the twins here, the bookends. And now, was it? Yes, well, these boys are really been very, very good to us. And I think they have something to say about Jim. You've skied with Jim, have you not, boys?
Yes, we have.
And what is it that Jim says?
Can he ski the shoot 75 shoot or what?
And what else?
Did I get up on a single ski or what?
Yes! this is a man who single skis, right?
That's the only reason we're here today, is to see him ski shoot 75.
Oh, I hope it's open. Maybe we can get him to hike up to Mainline Pocket and do a couple of flips.
He wouldn't want to stretch his abilities.
Okay. I don't blame you.
Lynn, am I the chubbiest guy who ever skied the Mainline Pocket?
You might be the oldest. I'm not sure. And a couple more gals that we'd like to introduce. This is Abigail. She's a little nervous today.
Embarrassed face in this whole crowd.
I think not.
I'm just stunned. There's no one else that's standing there looking sideways at all the people that are walking by, wondering what this group
is. Hey, you'll never see them again. What difference does it make to you, right? Besides,
how do you know?
Well, maybe tonight there'll be a sunny side.
Give me a job later.
Don't look for any dates. And we have Lee Haggerty, who had to come by herself because her husband couldn't make it. He had to stay home and take care of the dogs.
I know. I'm here for two reasons. One, to make sure this frigging party takes off. And two, to give Jim a few tips on bungee jumping before he does it about 1 o'clock. You think the blind skiing's going to be good. Wait, you see this.
And we have Angie, my former roommate. Actually, all the gals are my former roommates. So glad they could come to Jim's party. I invited all my friends to his party.
Now, Lynn, did we ever miss a party?
Absolutely not. Now, Angie, I do have a flash piece of news for you. They have changed the name of the hearthstone. It is now Rosie's. So when you go to Tahoe City, I don't want you in there looking for the hearthstone.
Thank you, Lynn, for that hot scoop. I hope my favorite corner is still there. I spent a lot of time balancing.
I think there's some floor space available.
Now, I just want to check on one more event of the afternoon. Are we going to be figure skating? Because I did bring my short skirt and my skates.
Well, you know, again, another person who had to wash their hair. Must be an epidemic. Our gal from the Ice Follies didn't show up.
Oh, no!
Yay! So I don't know if I may have to just turn this into a tutu or tutu what. I don't know. I may have to do a couple of pirouettes out there.
Well, I think these t-shirts will cover all of the events of the day.
I hope they cover everything. Now we have Donna Higgins. This is the sister-in-law of the person who turned 50, who she had a birthday this year too. But hey, I'm not going to say anything about how old she is, except she's older than I am. Anyway, Donna, do you have a couple words to say? Okay, that's enough. Donna's a woman of a few words. She doesn't really want to crash in on my time. Right, Donna?
That's right.
That's what I thought. Okay. Well, now,
Flash.
Uh-oh, news flash.
Franz Plummer will be here at 9:30 to challenge Jim on the dual slalom course.
Thank God he could make it.
He will be here. His plane did make it in from Kitzbühel, and he will be here.
And
so
Bryce,
the challenge is on.
I forgot to tell Jim. Did you tell him about the tragic event about Tempest Storm, who was going to be here?
I think that, you know, that is tragic. Tempest had planned to be here, but she did have an attack of arthritis on Friday afternoon. Is not sure she's going to be able to make it here. She had a problem getting her G-string on, so she may not be able to make the dinner and the entertainment tonight. But we are still hopeful that may occur.
Oh, thank you, Bryce. I'm so excited. Well there you have it.
Tell her to come without the G-string.
I know that you've tried to cover all the details of this party, but
this
did you, in fact, invite our friend?
Our pal, Jean-Claude.
Oh, I forgot the gals met him in, where was that gal?
Spent 4 days with him.
Did he know about it?
Kind of.
It was kind of like the world of Henry Orient.
What year was this when you were over there skiing?
1989.
I thought he died.
No, in fact, probably had you invited him. He does advertise those Rolex watches. This could have been the
Well, probably he would have showed up, at least stuck around for a while instead of someone else. Well, I guess we're going to head up to the race course now. And so I want everyone to just suit up, get the skis, and let's get ready to get up there. Okay, guys? All right. See you later.
We'll be right back.
We're real sorry we missed opening ceremonies today, but we want to be sure and wish you a fond welcome to the fabulous 50s. And that's Eric, Toby, and Brandon. They would have been there for opening ceremonies if they didn't like that quite as well as they do. Okay? Bye.
Because we like all of the snow that he brings us. All his
50 more years, Jim.
Give me something special.
Let me think about it.
Why don't you kiss the camera? That was nice, I appreciate it.
Thank you. classy in a breakfast mess. Yeah, 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 yeah. Let's play Twister, let's play Risk. Yeah, 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 yeah. I'll see you in heaven if you make the mess. Yeah, 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 yeah. Now, Andy, did you hear about this one? Tell me, are you locked in the punt? Andy, are you goofing on Elvis?
This is the only trick Lynn would let me do, the sawing in half. Was not allowed. I'm going to do the great Jim Mullen blindfold act. I haven't done it for 33 years, and I need someone to help me out. Is there a doctor in the house? Well, that's okay. Is there a nurse? Is there a health professional of any sort? That's all right. Okay, well, we'll try for... Where's Brian York?
Brian.
Oh, Kevin's my assistant. Kevin, well, he might be in cahoots. I'll use Brian. You come down here. These are these are to ensure safety. I always cover my eyes with the gauze pads. Are you ready? Put that on. Hold that against the eye there. Okay, great. And let's see. And put this, just attach this on carefully. Carefully, straight down like that. Just kind of stick it on both sides. Got it on there. So you got it on? Okay. And get this one here. All right, get that one on. Okay, can you take the, can you take this off? Let's see.
You hold the.
Okay. There's a short one. You can put the short one on and then the long one across. Uh-oh. Get that on there. Good. Okay. We got that? Okay.
Move the fingers.
Okay, move that. Okay. Now put one all the way across.
All the way across.
All the way across, yeah.
You have a helmet?
Attach it very well.
Okay.
Okay, now put the blindfold on. I don't think I'll be needing this.
This kind of reminds
me. Okay.
Take that.
Oh my, oh, remember that? Oh, I gotta, wait a minute. There's a problem, I can't see a thing.
Too bad. That's no point.
Okay. Wow, this is not good.
Who is this guy? Who's this man?
Okay, I'm gonna take this off. This is impeding my ability to.
Oh, I see, use your ears, dude.
Oh yeah, they do it all with the ears.
Okay, are we ready?
Wait a minute. Okay. And put the, you got the blindfold on. Oh, good. Oh, excellent.
Can you
which way? This way? Hi, Jeannie.
That's
all right, are you ready?
Right,
oh, yeah. I gotta get the right glove on.
Oh,
let me have a glove. Anybody have a glove? Oh, it's on my pole. Oh, I got problems here.
Yeah, we'll put your headband back on.
Okay.
Are you scared?
Oh, I'm nervous now. 33 years of no practice. Well, I'll tell you, it's not great, but I take my mints every day, about 50. Do I have these? About 15 aspirins to get myself out on the slope. And after that, it's just easy cruising, easy cruising. My big goal this year was making the 75 shoot right after my 50th birthday and making the mainline pocket. It was a glorious life experience.
So you did it?
Absolutely did it. I was up there with Kathleen. I had never met Kathleen before. We bonded at the top of the mainline pocket. Fear had taken over. and Lynn egged me on. I would never have done it were it not for Lynn saying, come on, Jim, today's your day. You're 50. It's time to do the mainline pocket, the Glen Plank of Squaw Valley, USA, and Los Gatos, Cal.
Mr. Bungee guy.
Mr. Bungee guy.
No comment. I'm on film. I don't want
to. No comment, she said.
Okay, Joel, have you ever jumped before?
Nope.
Oh, right on. I love first-time jumpers. Can you turn this way so we can see your backside?
Put your arms up just a little bit. Perfect.
Jumper status.
Okay, Joel, come in and face me. I'm going to check your wrist one last time. 165. Beautiful. That's all right. That's your weight. Yeah. Okay, can you go forward or backwards? Okay, Beth, at your convenience, I need a systems check. What's gonna happen is I'm gonna get you out to the platform, you're gonna step with your right leg over the cord, and I'm gonna back you up into the jump position, okay? All right, I'm gonna hold it.
I've seen her, I'd be the witness.
A 3-2-1 bungee countdown. On bungee, all you need to do is lean back, go like the nest tee plunge, okay? Keeping your eye on me as you fall away from the bridge. Don't push off with your feet so hard that you go backwards head first.
Just fall back.
Fall with your back parallel to the ground, okay? Okay, so go ahead and back on up. Also, too, remember, make sure to do what you do with your hands and do that force exercise. You got 6 inches in front of your face. Yeah, right there. That's perfect. Cool. Get rid of that.
That's so cool.
You start to do the force exercise with your hands in front of your face. Just in case the bag comes up. And then on your subsequent rebounds, don't grab the beaners, the bag, or anything.
It's awesome.
Take a bunch, let's count him. 3, 2, 1, punch it! Anytime grab the bag, the cord here, the beaners, or your harness on your subsequent rebounds. Just let them bounce, okay?
I know that.
So, what I want you to do now
touch the step of your right foot. Is it about?
Oh, Michael.
Michael, and I just want you to put it right here. Just like stay there.
Making
a thing and hold it.
Scoutmaster to jump captain. How much flag is in that cargo strap?
It's fine.
That's a 10-4. The ground is clear.
Thank you very much, Grunt.
Okay, nice firm grip. Okay, I'm gonna give you a 3-2-1 bungee. I want you just to lean back and let go like the nasty plunge on bungee.
Lean back and let go, don't jump.
You can push out a little bit, but just make sure you.
Hey, Michael. All right, let's count him down. 3, 2, 1, bungee!
Don't push yourself so hard that you go over backwards and go head first.
Just plane out so that you're falling.
Let go, baby.
Let go, just a single push of your feet to get out of
there.
Oh my gosh.
All right, we got Drake here. He's ready to take the bunch plunge. Let's count him. 3, 2, 1.
I'm on the video. Hey, how you doing, Mom? I love you.